Airways workshop. Now, first of all, guys, I would like to tell you that I have changed the location of my workshop. I was not getting any proper room in my house, so I moved to my grandmother's house. So I got this room over here where I have kept all my stuff, like all the tools and the power tools that I view daily. So guys, I'm making this video because I got a lot of views and a lot of likes on my video that I posted on my air blower, that is the Jakmister Air Blower. Yeah, that's a local brand, but yeah, it got a lot of views and it got a lot of likes. Alright guys, so thank you for your support, but I didn't find that video exactly like it was not worth watching because I hadn't spent any time on the video, virtually spent only 5 minutes on the video, and it was completely unedited, it was completely wrong, and I had no plans for that video. I just posted it on YouTube and like you guys loved it so much. Thank you for your thank you for your support, guys. Now today I'm gonna repost that video. Like I'm gonna make a newer video on the air blower in which I will explain the air blower in detail, and I'm also going to open it up to show you what is inside the air blower. Like, you know guys, if you see the air blower from inside, you will be like, you would find it really helpful to understand the principle of the turbochargers that are used in the engines. So guys, I would also like to tell you that I have a lot of power tools. Like for home use, there are a lot of power tools. So you can see guys, I have the air blower, the angle grinder, the heat gun, the drill machine, the jigsaw, and two of my power tools are yet to arrive. That is the circular saw. It is a Stanley circular saw, a 1600 watt circular saw, and an electric screwdriver for like driving the screws inside the wood. Like you can't use a drill machine instead of the screwdriver because the RPM of the screwdriver is really low. Like drill machine works on 2800 RPM, but the screwdriver works on 750 RPM. So that's approximately 1/4. So you're gonna get four times more torque than the drill machine has on the screwdriver. So that's a really good tool. I'm gonna post a review on that. So guys, but you have to wait because of the COVID-19, the deliveries have stopped and I'm not getting any more supplies. So well, you know guys, even my 5000 rupees that I spent on my circular saw, I also stuck with Moglix. So I can't help it, but you have to bear with it. I'm sorry guys. Alright guys, so let's start the video. So guys, here is the blower. You can see I also have the case of the like the carton of the blower in which it came intact till now. You can see what all is written. It says heavy duty, more powerful and reliable motor, high powered blower, professional tools. However, it's not a professional tool, mind my words. And over here you can see the same things written. It do comes in a variety of colors, but I love the color blue, and thankfully Amazon gave me the blue color, so I'm quite satisfied with this. So let's open it up. Okay, so guys, I'm opening it up. You can see. So, now this is an attachment that goes on both sides of the blower where it blows the air out and it sucks the air in. Because this blower works, has a dual purpose, like it also works as a vacuum cleaner, but the vacuum function of the blower is too weak. So let's show you the wheel blower. So guys, this is the wheel blower. And we also have a warranty card on the blower, inside the packet of the blower. You can see, it has a 6 months warranty. Well, that's long gone, because it's around 1 year that I've bought the blower. Like, I bought the blower like around 1 year back. So the warranty is long gone. So this is the blower, and there's nothing inside the case. Now guys, you can see this is the blower. Okay, so there's the fan of the blower, the main blower motor. It says Jakmister over here. It has a switch. It is not a speed variable blower, so it has only single speed. When you click this switch, it's just a toggle switch. It's like a toggle switch. It does not have the PWM speed controller, and you can even lock the switch by this button over here. Just press the switch and it will get released. Press the switch, press the button, release the switch, release the button. Now it is locked, and whenever you plug this blower in, it will blow at its full speed. Alright guys, so this is the motor. This is the motor this is the motor of the blower. Can see over here what is it? It's a 700 watt motor, and the blower fan
It puts around 2.7 meter cube per minute of air, and the fan rotates at 16,000 RPM. Well, that's a lot. That's a lot of speed. You know, even the engines, the F1 engines can only rev up to 15,000 RPM. And normal car engine, like for example my dad's car, the CRS, it has a rev limit of 6,500 RPM. So you can now you can see why the 16,000 RPM is a huge number. So let's keep this aside. Now this, this is the attachment that fits right on the top of the blower. It has these two locking pins. It's not of really great quality, but like it's working for me. As I said in my previous video, you can see now the blower will suck air through this vent over here, and then blows the air out. So guys, this type of blower is called a centrifugal blower, because it uses centrifugal forces to push the air out of the mouth of the blower. So, and it creates a partial vacuum over here. You can also attach this thing over here, this attachment over here, and now it will work. Sorry guys, it's not quite going inside. Just a second. Yeah, now it will work as a vacuum cleaner. It will suck the air inside and blow the dust out from here. You can also attach your garbage bag, not a garbage bag, but a vacuum cleaner filter to this side, but the company doesn't provide any vacuum cleaner filter, so this will just blow the dust out of here. And I'm talking about the tiny dust particles, because the filter over here will block the big particles. Like when the blower was new, I tried to suck in some thermocol pieces, and this just clogged the screen over here. So let's open the blower. Now guys, if you need to service, or like you want to change the blower mode, like the fan, the blower fan over inside the blower, you can open the blower like using any of the tools. Either you can use this normal screwdriver, these are flat head screwdriver, or you can use these long ones, or you can just buy this. This is a screwdriver set. It has each and every bit inside. So this eventually, this is a tester. It's not it's not only a screwdriver, it's also a tester. So let's open the blower. Alright guys, so you can see, this is the main fan of the blower. It spins like this, and it just, oh man, I can see a cracked. This is not a very good quality fan, but I have to bear with it. So it just spins, and by the centrifugal forces that acts upon the air, that is like air is everywhere, you know guys. Okay, so the air inside the air gets pushed to the outer surfaces and is forced through this hole. If you look through the complete assembly, you can see why it pushes the air. So as it pushes the air outside, it creates vacuum inside here, and then the air from here flows inside to these blades, and that also get pushed through this opening. So that's how this blower works, and this is the same principle on which the turbos work. So the one side of the turbo that pressurizes the intake air and sends it to the intercooler, it is similar to this thing over here. So guys, let's put the blower back to one piece. Now I'm just gonna screw this back over here. Guys, this is pretty much it. And like, if you need to replace the brushes of the blower, you have got this. This is the, like, you can just replace the brushes over here. These are like last screws in which you can put a screwdriver and just twist them. The brushes will come off. I'll show you. So guys, these are the carbon brushes. Now I'm gonna put this back. Similarly, you can just change this brush also. if you want to change, and you have to do it frequently because this motor spins at a very high speed. So do change the brushes frequently. My brushes are not worn out much because I don't use this blower too frequently. So, but you have to do regularly check these brushes, otherwise the armature will get damaged and then you have to get the armature changed, and it's a costly process if you do it from outside. But if you buy the armature on your own and change it, then it's gonna be very simple. But you can't change this because you need a bearing puller to pull the bearings off the armature, and then you have to like reinsert the brake like the bearings into the new armature and then change the blower. So that's not a very good option. So guys, be careful. Do not let the carbon brushes fail. Do check them regularly. Alright guys, now I'm gonna use my variable AC voltage power outlet. Like, I have installed an SRC voltage regulator that uses a triac. Triac is a semiconductor device. I'm gonna explain it in a few videos that will precede my videos that I'm currently doing on my car. So, okay, so guys, please don't get worried about this wire over here. This is not a short circuit because the outlet over here was damaged. So I just connected this wire in series with this outlet so I can measure, so I can just clamp on this wire outlet and measure the current going to a device that is currently connected on this outlet. I'll show you in a moment. But first of all, let's power the blower. So guys, I just turned, my other switch is already on. I'm just gonna turn up the MCB. The MCB was also up, sorry guys. I'm just a careless guy. So, this is the blower. I'm just gonna plug it in. This pouch over here. Now it's set at its minimum voltage level. Now, I'm just gonna press the trigger of the blower. You can see. You can see it rotating, right? So this root radius here, you can see, and the air current at its minimum power is also too high. The air current in this minimum power is also too high. So guys, this is a really powerful blower. So be careful not to just blow away your screwdrivers, etc., because this does blow away your screwdrivers if they are kept on the table and they can just fly off. So be careful while using the blower. Now I'm gonna slowly increase the voltage going to the blower. So guys, this is a really powerful blower. You saw that this screwdriver just flew off. Now I'm gonna test another screwdriver, but being careful not to hit something. So let's do it. So like, okay, now it's at its full power. You can see the screwdriver just blew off. You can see how powerful it is, and just don't underestimate its power. It's a 700 watt blower. I'm just gonna show you the current reading. So guys, this is my AC current clamp meter. You can just clamp the wire through which you want to measure the current, and it uses the magnetic flux, I'm sorry, the magnetic fields of the wire to detect the current, and it is accurate when the current is higher. Like if the current is higher, like in the range of 200 amperes to 1000 amperes, like you have these type of currents in the welding machine, so that's pretty accurate over there. But it's not as accurate in 1 to 3 ampere range, so I'm just gonna put it in the lowest range, that's the 200 ampere range over here, and just clamp this wire. Now you see why I designed this wire over here. Now, just a second, yeah, it realigned itself to show itself to the camera. So let's power the motor at its full speed. You can, the current that will be displayed initially will be the startup current of the motor. Now, 3, 2, 1. You saw that the startup current of the motor was around 2.3 ampere. Once again, Now it showed 2.5 ampere, 2.3 to 2.5 ampere. That's a lot of power. Well, for the accurate measurement, I'm just gonna connect my accurate meter, the accurate current meter, in series with this outlet. I'll show you in a moment, but the continuous current of the blower, you will just see in a moment. Now this shows you the continuous current of the blower. That's 1.6 ampere. Well, that's also a really great value. So, just a moment, I'm just showing you my other meter in series with this blower. So guys, I'm back with this meter. Now this is a pretty accurate meter. So I'm gonna select the, I'm gonna probe the range of 20 amperes. So it connects to the shunt inside and that can handle the 20 ampere current. So, and let's put it to AC current setting. And guys, if you would like to see how to use a digital multimeter, then I'll also make a video on this topic. Just comment me in the comment section below. Now you can see I've selected the 20 ampere AC. This is the sign for AC for my viewers who don't know electronics. There will be a very few of my viewers that who don't know electronics because I'm an electronics freak. So this is the 20 ampere. Alright. So guys, I think I've just hooked up everything all right. I don't know why I'm so scared by turning this thing on. Well, let's turn this. Yeah, nothing blew up. Let's see how much juice we can extract from this blower. You can see, now increasing the current. Guys, you just saw that my meter displayed a maximum reading of 2.1. I think it was 2.1 ampere. So this blower is indeed really powerful. Like, I think that accounts to around 600 watts of power. So guys, this is a really good blower. I'm just gonna disconnect everything because I've just live wires exposed over here. I don't wanna short anything. Yeah, I think I'm safe to remove this. Yeah. So guys, that's pretty much it. Hope you like the video. If you like the video, then do hit the like button and comment about how can I improve the quality of my videos. Like, hit the like button only if you really like the video. Otherwise, I'm not desperate in a desperate need of likes and subscribers because I'm not doing it for my job. The YouTube is not my job. So thanks for watching, guys.